these dolphins are top of the food chain, and they are the biological indicator of the environment, or a canary in the mine. Whatever happens to them will eventually happen to us.
No one will ever forget it, the 86 days last year that BP's broken oil well was dumping 200 million gallons of crude into the sensitive ecosystems of the Gulf of Mexico. Now scientists worry that there's a connection between that environmental catastrophe and the dozens of baby dolphins that have been washing ashore in Alabama and Mississippi. Craig went down to find out what is killing the dolphins. Here's Craig.
Carl DeWitt, the Institute for Marine Mammal Studies in Gulfport, Mississippi, where they're trying to find out what's killing the dolphins. In the past day, five more dolphins were found stranded on the beaches. So they're going to do what's called a necropsy today. It's an autopsy for dolphins. So far, 67 bottlenose dolphins have washed up on Gulf beaches over the past few weeks. More than half are babies.
There is concern because this is an anomaly. We have many more numbers right now than what we've had in the past.
The Institute's veterinarian, Dr. Connie Chevis, is examining the dolphin, trying to determine if there's a link between last year's deadly oil spill and the abnormal spike in dolphin deaths along the coast. This is more than normal, and you're expecting that if this is the way things are going, then it could get even worse next month.
Yes, we are concerned because March and April are the times when we normally would get more animals, and 10 to 20 per month. So we are already up to 30 in February, which normally we get 1 to 2 animals.
But the spill is not the only factor they're considering.
Well, we're looking at several things: viral, bacterial, infectious, algal bloom, temperature changes. So there's a lot of different factors.
The timing of dolphin deaths is particularly alarming. BP's Deepwater Horizon rig blew up on April 20th. Gestation for dolphin calves is 11 to 12 months.
These dolphins were conceived in probably March, April, or May of last year, close to the time when the oil spill occurred.
Part of what the Institute does is they rescue animals from the Gulf. They're in distress. A number of these loggerhead turtles were actually rescued covered in oil.
We had over 300 turtles that we picked up dead off of the beach. So that kept us very busy.
Direct result of the spill.
Well, it was during the time of the oil spill. We can't say that it definitely was the oil spill that caused it.
Speak like a real scientist. Or politician. I'm not sure which. While some dead calves found have what looks like oil on their bodies, what they consumed is also cause for concern.
The dolphins represent the top of the food chain.
If there's something wrong with the dolphin, then there's something wrong with the food chain that goes on the way down.
As sentinels, that's what we theorize, and that's what we expect, yes.
One theory, pregnant dolphins consumed contaminated fish, then passed it on to the fetuses. Stillborn, premature births, and in some cases, death shortly after birth. These samples will be taken and sent to a national forensic lab to put the pieces of the puzzle together.
What do you do if you do determine that it is from the oil?
Well, that will be out of our hands because we're not prosecutors. All we do is collect the data and then pass it on to the government or other people.
Craig's in New Orleans live tonight. Scary stuff, brother. What about the birthing cycle of these baby dolphins? Is that why this is so significant?
Well, it is, Geraldo, because they fear that the worst is yet to come. March and April, we could see the numbers double, even triple to what we're seeing now. So you can imagine that tragic sight. But researchers are determined to find all the ways that the oil spill in the Gulf has affected the ecosystem. And they're going to investigate every animal until they know for sure what killed them.
And so the dolphins on the top of the food chain, they're like our canaries in the coal mine then?
Exactly. Now, what they're going to do. Now, federal investigators have so far determined that the food system, I mean, that's the main thing that we're concerned about here, is what the dolphins are consuming, or possibly what we're consuming. But so far, investigators have determined that the food coming from the Gulf.
Still don't know.